famous for its numerous, large-sized teeth, to the extent that the name Megalodon is literally interpreted meaning big tooth or megatooth. If you've ever seen any documentary on the Mosasaurus, which was pretty much the same size as Megalodon, then you won't find it hard to imagine the phenomenal size of this shark. Several mysteries shroud this prehistoric shark, and as a result, documentaries and caught-on-camera footages which show apparent sightings of this gigantic marine predator are often a popular attraction. In fact, we have another video in which we have compiled several Megalodon sightings. You will find this video in the info box. But what exactly makes the Megalodon a phenomenal predator that inspires awe and strikes terror in the hearts of all its prey? And why did it become extinct? Dominating the world's entire ocean for about 20 million years and reaching lengths up to 65 feet, that's about 20 meters, one would have expected that Megalodon would be alive up to this present day, given the fact that it was the apex predator with no natural enemies and a worldwide distribution. However, about 3.5 to 2 million years ago, Megalodon simply vanished from our oceans. What could have caused such a formidable predator to have simply disappeared with no traces? Or even a complete skeleton except teeth? Well, researchers have advocated several theories, and in this video, we will consider the major, most plausible, and widely accepted theories which attempt to explain the cause of the extinction of the Megalodon. The reasons advocated by these theories include 1. Closure of the Central American Seaway and other environmental changes. 2. Loss of protective nursery habitats due to drastic drop in sea levels. 3. Radiation. 4. Drastic drop in ocean temperatures. 5. Inability to self-regulate its temperature. And 6. Decrease in food sources and increase in competition. Let us consider these theories one after the other. The closure of the Central American Seaway between 7 and 2 million years ago is argued by some scientists as the principal cause of the extinction of the Megalodon. The Central American Seaway closed when the Pacific tectonic plate was forced to slide underneath the Caribbean plate, thereby causing a land bridge which separated the Atlantic Ocean from the Pacific Ocean while connecting North and South America. The closure of this seaway due to the emergence of the Isthmus of Panama ensured that the Megalodon was cut off from the tropical migratory route it once employed. Furthermore, this closure caused a drastic change in ocean currents, creating disastrous ecological problems. Another disastrous environmental change is the expansion of the seafloor, which led to the creation of the Gulf Stream. This expansion brought about the slowing down and upwelling of nutrient-rich water from the seafloor. Upwell waters were important for Megalodon, as it provided tropical waters with the nutrients necessary for the sustenance of their biodiversity. In other words, several marine animals starved, and so probably did Megalodon, which fed and depended on them. The loss of protective nursery habitats due to drastic drop in sea levels is yet another contributory factor to its extinction. Megalodon bred in shallow, temperate waters. But, as hinted earlier, that there were ecological changes caused by the drastic change in ocean currents. Much of Earth's water was locked up in thick ice glaciers upon the advent of the last ice age, causing the ocean to drastically reduce by about 650 feet. 200 meters. This reduction in ocean level caused Megalodon's nursery waters to either dry up or leave the pups exposed at the mercy of predators such as killer whales and false killer whales seeking for a juvenile 4 meters or about 13 foot long snack. It is a fact that a species that is unable to successfully raise offspring will eventually go into extinction. And this could have been the case with Megalodon. Another theory proposed by some scientists in explaining the extinction of Megalodon is that it may have simply been snuffed out by radiation from a supernova. This theory, which gained popularity in 2018, is said to be a product of research which identified a supernova, that is, an exploding star, or several supernovas as the cause of the extinction of the Megalodon. It is a fact that if a star happens to explode close enough to the Earth's atmosphere, Earthlings, inclusive of plants and animals, would be in trouble. The problem with radiation is that the bigger the living organism, the more radiation such organisms will absorb. Consequently, the more the radiation absorbed, the more fatal it will prove to be. Now, imagine a 65 feet or 20 meters long lumbering megalodon absorbing all that deadly radiation. The end result would be massive death within just a few generations. A fourth theory advocates that the drastic drop in global temperature is the major cause of the megalodon's extinction. During the Pliocene era, the temperature of the world's oceans plunged. Hence, megalodon was restricted to lower altitudes where the seas were warmer. Prior to this cooling, megalodon could have been found in places like Africa, South America, North America, Japan, India, Europe, and Australia. It had a worldwide distribution and could be found everywhere except the Antarctic. However, this eventual restriction to warmer waters limited the feeding range and food supply of the megalodon. This because its usual preys were able to adapt to the cool temperatures of higher latitudes, and as such could no longer serve as prey. Closely related to this is the surprising theory that megalodon was unable to self-regulate its body temperature. Unlike modern-day great white sharks, before its extinction, the temperature might have dropped tremendously. The megalodon was definitely set for doom, as it lacked the evolutionary capacity to thermoregulate in accordance to the decreasing temperature. In 2018, research was conducted with a view to determining the average body temperature of a megalodon, testing the teeth of modern-day great white sharks, since they are considered one of the closest living relatives, and that of megalodon. It was discovered that not only was megalodon probably unable to regulate its body temperature, but also that it possessed an exceptionally hot metabolic rate. Megalodon had an average body temperature that was as high as 104 degrees Fahrenheit, 40 degrees Celsius. On the other hand, the ancestors of the great white sharks, which shared the seas with megalodon while he was alive, had modest temperatures of about 86 degrees Fahrenheit, 30 degrees Celsius. Being exceptionally warm-blooded animals with no heat self-regulation, it is understandable that such a drastic fall in temperature could greatly affect the species adversely. The final major extinction theory of megalodon we will be examining in this video is that which proposes that decrease in food sources, coupled with increased competition, helped put a permanent end to megalodon. Megalodon's menu is said to have consisted of baleen whales, toothed whales, and early species of seals, sea cows, sea turtles, etc. However, its favorite were probably humpback whales. But did you know that towards the near end of the Pliocene era, when the Isthmus of Panama showed up, a lot of whales and other marine animals migrated to colder altitudes where the megalodon couldn't follow. Hence, it could no longer consume its usual 2,500 pounds, a bit more than 1,100 kilograms of food each day. Added to the scarcity of food was the fierce competition with great whites and killer whales for the scantly available prey. In conclusion, while some scientists advocate for a particular factor and others believe that it is a combination of several, the exact cause or causes of the extinction of megalodon remains a mystery. All we know about them is obtained from studying the numerous fossilized teeth they have left behind. With each producing up to 40,000 teeth in its lifetime, there are more than enough teeth waiting to be discovered. Thanks for watching. Let us hear your comments below. Please subscribe.